Memphis, D-55, Nassau, Bahamas, D-60K.
There's something about traveling to a forbidden country.
Getting ready to head out to, I'm trying to go to the beach, man. I have a friend of mine who I met a second ago. I already forget her name, but
hello.
My friend is waiting for me. Let me adjust these white balance settings.
Okay, now while I adjust these white balance settings, let me just give you a warning. This was my first day in Cuba, and my Spanish was horrendous on my first day. But gradually, as my trip progressed, my George Washington High School education Spanish class from San Francisco started to kick in.
So as I was saying, my friend is waiting for me. She's a nice girl. Hopefully she's not trying to take me for my money, because she has a shirt on that says, "Get over." And I'm not sure how to feel about that, but I don't think she knows what it means. But in America, if somebody says get over, that means they're a scam artist or they're trying to get over on you. So hopefully she's not trying to get over on me. There she is over there. She doesn't want to be on camera. She actually already told me that she wants $100 if she wants me to charge to pay her. Hola.
Hola.
Sí, es mi cámara.
Ah, Karina, Sony.
Canon. ¿Te gusta?
Una de las mejores.
¿Ah?
Una de las migliori, de las mejores.
Sí. So ahora necesitamos
almorzar.
¿Comida?
Sí, sí.
Y
ahora podemos ir pero a muchos lugares donde ir.
Pero hay comida en, a la Floridita.
Sí,
sí.
Claro, hay comida.
Okay, ¿so necesitas coche?
Claro.
¿Aquí?
It was at this moment that the adventure began. You see, my new friend here, Clyde, she had a dual citizenship from Cuba and Rome, so she was educated, she was well off, and she knew the city like the back of her hand.
Hacen cócteles de. Bueno, tú me invitas a mí, ¿no?
Yeah.
Bueno, tengo dinero. Hacen cócteles de. ¿Conoces el daiquiri?
¿Kiri?
Daiquiri. El daiquiri es la bebida de Ernest Hemingway.
Ernest Hemingway?
Yeah.
What you know about Ernest Hemingway?
Es de pescador.
Okay, so I gotta admit, I was really caught off guard by her knowledge of Ernest Hemingway.
Pescador.
I later found out that the author Ernest Hemingway became a fixture of Havana, and he actually stayed in the country a lot longer than many Americans chose to after the relations between Cuba and the United States began to deteriorate.
O posible. Sí, yo compro un coche para la día.
Para el día.
Es mejor, ¿no?
Sí.
Porque un taxi.
Ah, conviene.
Vale. ¿A dónde es el coche? ¿Aquí? No.
Sí, I'll show you.
Yeah, bueno. Porque es mejor, ¿no?
So my thinking here I thought was pretty logical. Rent a car, save money on taxis, and have this local girl who knows all about the city show me where to go. Seems simple, right?
Es el Berco Fly. So I told her I want to rent a car. I think it'll save money on taxis.
¿Eh?
Es mejor.
¿Un taxi?
Sí. No. Sí, es mejor.
You wanna ask her?
Sí.
Well, how How many days? 3 days, 4 days?
Mm, depends on the price.
Ah.
Hola.
Buena. Ah, okay. Oh.
So we didn't get the rental car right away. But after a couple of bike rides, or hopping on the back of bikes, we were able to finally find a rental car place that had decent prices. It'd be kind of funny, but finding a place that actually had rental cars was almost more difficult than finding an actual flight to Cuba. All I did was book a flight from LAX to Nassau, Bahamas, walked right over to Cubana Air, which is a Cuban-owned airlines, and next thing I knew, I was on a one-way trip to Cuba. There's a joy within the Cuban people that might just be one of a kind. The sounds of upbeat music, smells of flavorful food, and sultry sights of dance are all tossed into one big pot of expression, creating one of the most potent recipes for an enriching explosion of flavor to ever meet your palate.
You can wait for
a la izquierda.
You can wait here or come with me. Okay. A minute, you see. They see you can take some picture.
Not long after dropping off my friend Clyde, I followed her direction and headed towards Habana Vieja, or Old Havana, which is supposedly, for a photographer like me, a dream location. Check out some of my shots. I've never in my life been surrounded by such an aesthetically pleasing environment, where every direction I turned, I saw a new photo. Cuba is all about the people, and getting to know them and immersing yourself amongst their culture is what makes this trip a special one. After exploring many nooks and crannies in Habana Viejo, I found myself in a local market where I met a visual artist named Milton. He ended up showing me some of his artwork. He also talked about life in Cuba, traveling the world, and meeting people along the way.
The idea of the Cuba. Cuba is, or maybe the life, but more than Cuba. Today we are here, and you need to jump like this. Tomorrow. You need to jump. Mm-hmm. Tomorrow, you need to jump.
Mm-hmm.
It's my life. I'm energy prepared today for tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Tomorrow I know that I need to.
Yeah.
It's my life.
Sí.
All the time.
Todavía.
In Mexico, when I was in Mexico, I was invited for 2 girls. When I was in Mexico, first I was in Canada. Excellent. My friends are like my family now. After I visit Mexico, the first month, perfect. In the house of this person. One day in the house, in Mexico.
Mm-hmm.
Oh no, Milton, I don't like that, you stay here more. Why?
Mm.
No, I need to stay alone, go out of the house.
Mm.
No money.
Wow.
With my big camera, with my laptop, I use a Macintosh.
Oh, wow.
To the street.
In Mexico. Wow, peligroso.
Yeah.
Sí.
I'm asleep, I'm all the time nervous, and I meet people. 9 months.
9 months.
In Mexico.
Wow.
I lose the permission to stay in Cuba again. I need to renovate the.
Yeah.
Crazy, but good.
Yeah.
Because I can talk.
Experience.
And now.
Yeah.
I am the owner here. In Mexico, I selling this. Apart, I need to work the drive a car, and the owner.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
No, I like to this. No, it's like I say that like this is not like this.
Yeah.
I receive experience.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
9 months.
And now you're your own boss and you do what you want.
Yes. I am very happy because I live with my girl, my wife.
Mm-hmm.
I'm in the house, it's the gallery. I work in my wife help me. Quiet.
Yeah.
I work in here Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday.
Bastille.
Perfect.
I ended up talking with Milton for about an hour. After we spoke, I was craving more adventure and culture, so I got lost in a small neighborhood where I ended up stumbling across 2 teenage girls who were serving ice cream. It wasn't your typical ice cream shop. In fact, it was quite the opposite.
¿Tienes salado? Chocolate. ¿Cuánto cuesta?
El batido 5 y el vaso de 9 y 3. Jordan, ponme la canción que te dije. Dale, mijo. Ay, cómo me gusta. Jordan, no la quince.
Ya, dale, que es una sola. ¿Qué te pasa?
Vamos a hacerlo, papi.
Pero ven acá.
Lucreño.
Lugareño.
Lugareño.
No, no sé.
Yo quiero este también en el cup. ¿Cómo se dice?
Un vaso.
Sí, yo quiero uno más.
¿Tú eres brasileño?
¿Ah?
Brasileño.
¿Brasileño?
¿Tú?
No. Estados Unidos.
Ah, bueno.
No me gusta la chocolate.
Escucho, dime.
No. ¿Cuántos más?
¿Tú quieres un vaso ahora? Nueve.
¿No?
Nueve. ¿Te va?
Nueve. No. Necesito más.
¿Que necesito más?
Y sí.
De nuevo de tres. Hay de nueve, de dos bolis, de tres, de tres.
Amor mío.
Solo uno. Solo uno.
Sí.
Okay.
Ay, qué
cojones. Qué es chistoso. Yo. You not laughing at me. ¿Qué es chistoso? ¿Es chistoso?
No, no, no.
¿Es él? ¿Es tu hermano?
Sí, mi hermano.
Ok.
¿Qué te pongo?
Chocolate.
¿Un maquillo aquí?
No, money.
Ay, ahí no puede. Ven acá, el
no, no solo jalado aquí por nueve. ¿Cuántos pesos?
Aquí tienes cinco.
Sí, bueno. ¿Solo nueve?
Son nueve. Te faltarían cuatro.
¿Necesitas más?
Sí.
¿Cuatro más?
Esos son cinco.
Cook. ¿Es un cook?
Sí, cinco cook. Son cinco pesos cubanos.
Ay, 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 yo estoy listo.
Ay, qué cómico.
Ay, ¿qué te están pidiendo?
No estoy cámico, no estoy cámico.
Ay, ay, sí.
No.
No, ningún país, no estoy para hablar inglés.
Es mucho. ¿Qué es chistoso? No es chistoso. Dime tú una basura porque no quiero esto.
¿Qué?
No, no me gusta.
Bótalo, bótalo.
Bota.
Vaya, vaya, vaya.
¿A dónde es la calle para el autobús?
El monte.
¿Cuántas calles?
Como dos cuadras.
¿Cuatro?
Dos.
Dos.
Uno. Bye.
Bye.
When traveling to a foreign country and venturing off onto unknown streets and territories, it's important that you always maintain your sense of direction. As I continued to explore the neighborhood, I couldn't help but notice that none of the streets were really straight. They all ended up curving and going different directions, and it's very easy to get lost and confused as to which way is the right way. So I do like any tourist does, and I started asking questions to the locals about a street by the name of Lugareño. And to my luck, nobody seemed to know where Lugareño Street was, or had they ever even heard of it.
Necesita el calle de Lugareño. No conozco. Permiso. Te conozco a dónde es el calle de Lugareño. ¿Ah? Arriba.
Mira, toda la calle Lugareño.
¿Calle de Lugareño?
¿Cuál? Lugareño.
Sí, es una calle posible 5 minutos, pero no sé.
¿Qué pasa?
Necesito ir al Lugareño. Es
pero no te dijeron
en
qué lugar de La Habana.
Sí, es en La Habana, pero es posible 5 minutos caminando. Lugareño. No sé. Ok. 5 minutos caminando. ¿A dónde es el malecón? ¿Allá?
Malecón. No. Allá. Allá, pero es que en malecón no hay Lugareño. Yo estoy aquí.
Malecón es no. That way.
Agua
este.
El P8 y te deja en el malecón.
¿Malecón este, güey?
Y la 16 te deja en el malecón. Shit.
¿A dónde es el Capitolio?
Ah, para allá, tiene que ir para allá. Mira, vamos.
Como una, dos, sí, tres. Como 7, 8 cuadras.
7, 8.
Arriba,
pues,
pero para llegar al malecón lo que le falta
un... No, a Capitolio
como 7, 8 cuadras.
Capitolio por lo menos 10 cuadras.
Okay.
Coge el P8.
Muchas gracias, muchas gracias. Okay.
I eventually found Lugareño Street and ended up meeting my new friend Clyde at a local Cuban restaurant that was serving traditional cuisine.
Okay. Tengo hambre.
Te y yo.
Mucho hambre, mucho.
Yeah. Ay, arroz, frijoles, siempre el típico.
Claro.
Con la música cubana.
Jugo.
Bueno,
¿sí para ventana?
Sí. ¿Posible? ¿Me miro?
Perfecto.
Manu, dos aquí. Arriba. Digo usted, diga.
Muchas gracias.
¿Ya?
Sí.
Listen to the authentic song of Guantanamera as we waited for our food to arrive. I enjoyed soft bread along with rice and beans that had a sweet flavor to it that I just couldn't resist. No matter your destination of choice, whether it be Cuba or some other far-off land, I encourage you to step out of your comfort zone and dare to live in the moment. Capture your dreams and help preserve the memories of a lifetime to cherish and to share with loved ones and strangers we meet along the way. Until next time, thanks for watching.
Cuba, they don't have basketball, so we play with coconuts.